I'm going to tell you about Seattle, Washington, and then I'm going. Seattle, Washington is a city, as far as the weather is concerned, they're a little backwards. And in Seattle, they have rain at least 365 days of the year. So therefore, they don't know anything about the sun. As a matter of fact, they think that the sun is evil. You know, when the sun comes up, what did we do? Is our town bad? You know, what have we done? You know, and they go out and they cut a calf, you know, and put them up on a rock. You know, that kind of thing. But, no, that's the truth. And you can see them out there. They don't know the difference. You know, they're out there on the beach when it's raining, getting a rain tan. You know, they're out there. And they think the more wrinkled the body, the better you look. You know, really. That's all. You look like a prune. Thanks a lot. I appreciate that. You know. And you ask anybody from Seattle, says, do you like the sun? No. Why? Dries up the sinuses. That's why. You know, can't breathe. Got little gull slits on their raincoats, you know, stuff like that. And in Seattle, they have this gorilla, and his name is Bobo. And the veterinarians have been going mad trying to get Bobo to mate. This is the truth. Bobo is about 54 years old now. And it's costing the zoo an awful lot of money because he's the only gorilla that they have, and they want to get another one. So the way to do it is, you know, to call up a zoo, send up, for them to send up a female gorilla, and then they mate, and then they get a little gorilla, and then you do that twice, and you get a gorilla, and then the old gorilla can die off if he wants to, you know, which is less expensive than hiring Clyde Beatty to go out there and get you one, you know. So, and more fun for the gorilla, too, you know. But Bobo knows nothing about mating. You know, he just sits there. And, you know, the vets keep saying, come on, Bobo, pretty soon you'll be too old. Nothing, you know, you're gone. And so he just... And as a matter of prestige, too, other zoos keep calling up, and they know about Bobo, and they keep making fun of him. You know, it's, nah, 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 your gorilla don't know nothing. You know, that kind of thing. But the guys from the Philadelphia Zoo were very nice about the whole thing. They closed up their zoo. And they sent up their best-looking female gorillas. And she went into the cage with Bobo, and she was looking good, too. She had long black stockings on, you know, and some heavy eye makeup. And they gave her a girdle with hair on it, you know, and she was looking very shapely. She went into the cage and boom, 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 boom. And he did nothing. He was just... And, of course, she stormed out of there. Well, this left the vets to try different methods. And one guy thought he had a good thing going. He went in and he read him dirty stories. And that didn't work, even the parts underlined. And then another guy went in and he showed him some gorilla stag movies. You know, where the gorillas have black tape across their eyes so you can't tell who they are or nothing like that. And he walked out in the middle of the stag movie, and the last method they tried was they took some darts and they dipped them into this special gland secreting stuff that they got from an old sailor. There's a box marked Tijuana COD, you know. And they took the darts and they threw him and hit him in the back. And the darts did nothing to him. He just pulled away and pulled him out and he threw him away and they hit a hippo. And the hippo went wild. I mean, everything. Birds, trees, grass, garbage cans. He was all over the place there. As a matter of fact, they have some of the weirdest looking animals out in that zoo now. They have a giraffe with a hippo's head and his neck can't hold the head up. You know, it keeps going down in the ground. That's a true story, though. You don't believe it. Yeah.